Now, I'd be a liar if I sat up here and said that I know what's going on in the immediate DC universe. Whether you worship Beerus, Kratos, or Bruce Almighty, if it's one thing I know, it's that God does not like liars. When I was heavy into reading comic books, I was more of a Marvel guy. Outside of the core Justice League, I couldn't tell you much about DC Comics. Actually, that's not true, because even in the core, there's one person I'm not that familiar with, and that's Captain Marvel, or some of you might know him as
Shazam!
Now, before the film came out, all I could tell you about Captain Marvel was that he was a kid named Billy Batson, and when he shot at Shazam, he was granted powers similar to Superman. And that's because the only superhero named Billy that I grew up watching was Billy Madison.
Oh my God, that is funny!
It really wasn't. I just wanted to sneak a Billy Madison reference in the video because, truthfully, it would have been too easy to mention that. Okay, I swear I'm done with the jokes. For now, let's turn our attention to today's topic, Shazam's arch-villain, the anti-hero known as Black Adam. When this movie was first revealed, I'm not gonna lie, I didn't care. My only knowledge of Black Adam came from the Injustice video games. I mean, he seemed like a cool character, but between Static Shock, Black Lightning, Storm, Miles Morales, Aqualad, Juice, Black Vulcan, Soul Power, Black Lightning's daughters, Lightning and Thunder, and the list goes on, by the way. Of black people with electric superpowers. But then I saw something on Twitter that changed my mind about Black Adam. It was something so profound and so inspirational that it made me purchase a ticket. And that thing was,
hey everybody, Dwayne Johnson here. I'm inviting you to check out the Black Adam Experience on Roblox.
I said, okay, Black Adam's in Roblox? I'm seeing this movie, goddammit. And listen, I had zero expectations for Black Adam. I mean, The Rock's a great guy, but his acting chops are a little bit limited, if we're being honest. He plays himself in every movie, so I wasn't sure if he would be able to portray such a complex character on a silver screen, especially after it was released to mixed reviews. I just wasn't sure if this film would be electrifying or not. But I'm happy to report back that not only did I enjoy this film, but I don't understand some of the hate it was getting. By the way, this is coming from someone who has found most of the DCU's offerings to be weak. I mean, I was literally sitting through this movie shocked, like, wow, I think I like this movie. First off, The Rock looked great in the cape. All that real life discipline really paid off, seeing as it wasn't a scene in the movie that looked like he struggled to carry that heavy ass head on his shoulders. See, most of y'all don't know, The Rock got that nickname from his grandma because his head is as big as an Indiana Jones sized boulder. All right, that didn't actually happen. I just wanted to make a joke. Actually, seriously, don't kick my ass, Mr. Dwayne. Matter of fact, I'll make it up to you. I'm going to tell my editors to promote your new energy drink for that joke. Hey, editors, can you roll in some of that Zoa energy footage?
Number one fastest growing energy drink in the game. Amazon, the number one deal of the day on Amazon right now. 24 hours, the deal of the day. All flavors of Zoa, all Zoas. Our forecast for Zoa Energy will be a $1 billion brand valuation.
I loved Black Adam's backstory. Once again, I am not familiar with the source material, so I don't know what's true to the original and what's changed. I'm simply commenting on what's present in the film, and what's there is enough to where I was able to empathize with this morally gray character. And I can't stress enough how much I enjoyed the pacing of this movie. It hits the ground running and it never stops. But the crazy part is, the narrative gives you just enough meat on the bone to where I never got lost. I was able to follow everything going on without feeling lost watching the movie. The action scenes were on point for the most part. It's a lot of large-scale spectacles with explosions, buildings falling, and testosterone levels
over 9,000.
Now, I know this is a Black Adam film, but in my humble opinion, the star of the show is Dr. Fate, played by James Bond, Pierce Brosnan. This silver fox steals the show with his charming bravado, wisdom, humor, and awesome fight scenes. I thought Dr. Fate was cool in the Injustice games, but I never really wanted to see a solo film until Black Adam. The CG in Black Adam was hit or miss, but during the Dr. Fate scenes, it really shined. I would love to see a film that further explores his origins, plus the relationship between him and Hawkman. The rest of the supporting cast of metahumans included Cyclone, Hawkman, and Atom Smasher. Cyclone can create tornadoes, and she's cute, so hopefully she can use her powers to blow me a kiss or something. Hawkman is straight out of Compton, so you know he's strong, but I didn't really enjoy Atom Smasher. He's basically DC's Ant-Man from a power and personality standpoint. I just didn't find him to be funny. He had this whole Asheroth, I love college type of humor. That being said, some of the humor did stick the landing in the movie. Most of it was because it wasn't forced. A lot of natural stuff like Black Adam not understanding the modern world and Dr. Fate being a sarcastic smartass, leading to more banter. I mean, the movie does stick some of its landings. What I don't think stuck the landing Landing was the villain. I mean, he wasn't terrible, but he didn't really stand out either. Just kind of your typical I'm gonna rule the world because I'm evil type beat. My only guess is maybe because Black Adam is already complex, the writers decided to go with a more generic bad guy for him. I just know that the CG was no bueno in the villain. Kind of reminded me of the poor CG in the Aquaman movies. There's just too much magic stuff going on that makes it hard to make it look real, and it ruins the immersion and the consistency of the movie. Overall though, DC finally got one. This is the first live action DC movie that I've enjoyed since the release of Shazam, funny enough. Seems like Captain Marvel and his rogues gallery are carrying the DCU right now. Go see Black Adam if you haven't already. This is the first movie that I've seen from The Rock where it felt like he wasn't playing The Rock, and I've been watching Rock movies since The Scorpion King. I haven't even mentioned what happened in the post-credit scenes, by the way, because that had some crazy implications as well. But in order for me to talk about that, just know we're moving into the territory of spoilers. All right, nerds, you've been warned. The spoilers are inbound. The after credits scene was so simple, yet fire. The whole time I was watching Black Adam, I was thinking, why was the Justice Society sent to handle Black Adam instead of the Justice League? Black Adam seemed like a serious threat, and then boom! Amanda Waller pops up, talks her shit, tells Black Adam to chill before she pulls out the big guns. Black Adam says he wanted all the smoke, and then within seconds, Henry Cavill's Superman is in Black Adam's face like, what was that woofing about? This was such a simple scene, yet some of you might be wondering to yourselves, well, why is this exciting? Twitter user I'm sorry if I butchered your name. She explains it better than I ever could. She said,
everyone owes The Rock a big thank you. Maybe it's wishful thinking, but I'm keeping my fingers crossed.
She went on to say,
from a production standpoint, this is a huge deal, especially considering they're trying to completely wipe Zack Snyder's universe.
Exactly. I like the Snyder cut of the Justice League. So what, it was 4 hours and displayed in the same resolution as an Instagram video. It was a good movie ruined by money-hungry corporate suits trying to control an artist's vision, and Black Adam, aka The Rock, said,
shut up, bitch.
So in conclusion, I'd like to end this video by saying, let the painters paint. All the suits need to be worried about is how they're going to sell the painting when it's done. If you're gonna question the artist every step of the way, then why even bother doing business with them? I'm just saying. Now with all that out of the way, if you made it this far into the video, I just wanted to remind you that
it's about drive, it's about power. ZOA 30% off on Amazon for the next few hours.